गुड आफ्टरनून,
गुड आफ्टरनून,
दिस इज डॉक्टर साई भास्कर रेड्डी. टुडे वी आर डिस्कसिंग विथ श्री सुधाकर रेड्डी गारु, एमिनेंट अग्रिकल्चरिस्ट एंड इंजीनियर, एस्पेशली ऑन द इंटीग्रिटी इन अग्रिकल्चर थ्रू मॉनिटरिंग एंड मैनेजमेंट विच इज वेरी मच लैकिंग इन अग्रिकल्चर सेक्टर. दिस इज बिकॉज ऑफ वेरियस फैक्टर्स वेयर ए फार्मर इज डिपेंडेंट ऑन. And in this regard, especially for sustainability to be achieved, there is a lot of things need to be improved. And today, let us discuss on the seeds aspect. As seed is the most fundamental thing in agriculture, which also reflects in production, yield, and the viabilities, as well as the livelihoods of the farmers are also related. And most importantly, the seed production globally is getting into the hands of the multinational companies. So there are few companies which are dealing with seed production, and of course regional and local, the farmers produced seed is also existing, but over a period the local produced seed is not able to sustain the food production. And most importantly, in the whole process of high yielding varieties and GMOs, we are also losing the local biodiversity, that is the varieties of seeds also. The sovereignty of the farmers is also under question. So considering this whole aspect of integrity in agriculture, including the recent seeds bill of 2019, which was discussed in the Indian Parliament, is also of importance. As India is one of the major agriculture countries and major producers and also exporter of many goods. So in this regard, I request Sri Sudhakar Reddy Garu to reflect upon.
Well, we all know the seed is an important input for agriculture. There need not be second thought. Seed has been the main thing for the ages, for centuries together, that kept the whole life going in the world. So seed actually, when this has been happening, you see, the agriculture has been happening help of seed. There used to be a number of seed varieties, see, all over, depending on the environments, the ecologies. The farmers used to follow those seeds, see, available to them. So the efficacy of seeds, see, used to be better in those days, because farmers knew as to what type of seeds, see, are more relevant and more appropriate to their soils. So there was absolutely no necessity of standards having needing standards, see, for those conditions, because the farmers themselves, see, were deciding standards by word of mouth. There used to be, you know, the standards going through a number of generations from grandfather to father to the children, you know, over generations. They used to understand the traits, see, by physical appearance. The errors, you see, were very minimal even through the generations. Now, when the climate changes started happening, the real integrity of the seed, apart from diversity versus ecology versus environment, are becoming factors now. Earlier, the environment and seed trait and then seed type used to be decided the farmer, you see, depending on the ecology there. But now came the question, when the population has increased, the rate of growth of population to the rate of productivity was not earlier matched. With the green revolution, when these seeds started, new seeds started, the scientists started developing these new seeds, the diversity factor has lost its meaning. Then came the necessity of evolving standards. because different seeds coming into the picture, necessarily you have to maintain the standards in Ipaka way, because they have to, wherever they are sold, whether they are sold inside the country or exported or they are imported from different countries, they have to meet definite standards because of the need for harmonization. Because what is relevant to Germany when they sell to India or when they export from India, these standards have become more relevant. The relevance of the standards was felt by the people for maintaining the integrity of the seeds. So irrespective of whether seeds, see, by virtue of their hybridization, they have lost the diversity in different places, because productivity was kept in mind. The profitability was kept in mind. When they took over, the integrity of the seed has taken a back seat. I'm not saying seeds are not qualitative. The meaning of the integrity of the seed has lost its meaning. So therefore, what I would like to emphasize is that when you keep the standards, the germinability is one aspect, the viability is another aspect, and then the vigor is another aspect. So here I mean, even if quality standards are there, seed acts are there, these do not fully represent the field conditions. There is another factor coming in that's called seed health. When seed quality is good and you have purchased from a foreign country from a different source within the country, the quality of seed having been conforming with the standards may not meet the health standards when you really think of the time of sowing seed, because in the process of the quality of seed is different from health. Hello?
Yes, sir. Continue, sir.
Here the meaning of health is when you have purchased the seed as per standards from whichever source it is, whether from foreign source or from indigenous source at a distance. The traits of the quality of the seed in terms of quality might have been there, but eventually when it goes through various stages during its sowing, up to sowing process, either during the moment from the harvesting place or from the supplier place, the handling would be there, transportation would be there, and then the storage will be there. During these process, the seeds might have been subjected to different stresses. And with the result, what happens is the quality is suffering. The health of the seed is suffering eventually, depending on to what degree of stress this has been subjected to, either in environmental aspects or from storage aspects or from the pest angle. So the farmer will have to think in these terms. We can't blame the seed acts like the seed suppliers. The problem lies with the custodian, that is the farmer who has to maintain these seeds. So this aspect is not given stresses anywhere. As a farmer, I noticed, having purchased best hybrid seed, if this is not followed, then I'm only subjected to sufferance in my own hands for not having kept up the health aspects properly. There is another factor involved in seed that is called dormancy. Seed being very good, if these characteristics are not observed properly, the integrity of the seed is also in doubt. You can't blame a supplier for the dormancy that is vested in seed. So these factors, these farmers will have to come to know that there is a factor called dormancy, depending on the type of seed, whether it is 15 days dormancy, which means even if seed is good, when you try to sow, within 15 days or 30 days, depending on their dormancy period, there will not be any germination. You can't attribute this to the bad quality. So when such factors are involved and such factors do matter, definitely the quality is not represented by such extraneous factors, such invisible factors unknown to the farmer. There has to be proper education for the farmer. So that is one aspect coming to the quality. After the quality, there is another factor. After quality, as I mentioned already, the health is another factor, which can be taken care by proper handling, you see, during the harvesting. Why, for instance, for that matter, these combined harvesters are not doing their job today. The most of the seeds, you see, are getting lost in the field to an extent of 15 to 20%, depending on which type of composite harvesters we have used. The shield or sieve inside, which is meant for different sizes of the seed, or different types of the seed. If the sieve used for one size of red gram or pigeon pea in one area, if you can't change that sieve to another size, so it would automatically, the quality of the seed will be suffering, because some of them may not go through those and will escape, or some may go and then get crushed, you see, in the next process. Therefore, you can't expect proper integrity of the seed in terms of its size or in terms of its quality. So such factors also will come into the picture. This is where the universities will have to come into the picture and see that these proper sieves or proper mechanisms, you see, are going to the system to maintain its quality. These are the aspects that farmers would have to take into consideration. And there is another factor called the traceability. This is where I told the number of governmental officials earlier, policymakers, that you have to definitely come into the technological aspects now. When there are no difficult technologies involved, absolutely, there should not be any problem for the governments to adapt these technologies, follow these practices. Like, for instance, you have label given in the seed. The branded manufacturers who give their QR code. When you deploy the QR code reader and then attach to a point of sale, which generates the so-called customer invoice, the customer invoice will specify the supplier's name, the type of the seed, and the what you call the shelf life of the seed. That is when this gets expiry date. Expiry date means the maximum time up to which the seed can be used. There is absolutely no expiry here. The maximum time within which you have to use this. Otherwise, you have to return the seed manufacturers. For any reason you are not able to use, you may have to request to take it back if the conditions agree. Otherwise, you have to keep it for next season if it is well with that maturity period. So the coming to the integrity part here means the traceability. If you are not able to trace your seed properly as to who has supplied to you, under what conditions you have been supplied, whether they have been supplied with proper conditions, like in the case of cotton, the Monsanto earlier used to stipulate a condition that there has to be non-BT and BT mixed, you see, in them, so that the pink ball worms, which are the pests that attack this cotton, will not become resistant. But unfortunately, what is happening is the deviations are there in the field and practices are changing, either due to the ignorance of the farmers or non-insistence of these practices by the field operatives, the extension operatives, or by non-insistence by the governments, by strict regulation by the governments. So these are all the factors that governments will have to think. And then encourage the farmer to follow these practices. That is one aspect. The other thing is to establish the efficacy of these seeds. You can't blame the seeds, you see, for improper management of the other later practices that are expected to be followed by the farmer with the guidance from the extension people. While the governments will have to definitely prevail on these extension people to see that these seeds that came with through proper integrity and by not following these management practices, the farmer should not be subjected to any sort of loss, you see, in the field. So these are all the things. By integrity, I mean when we follow the traceability, in case the farmers have the problem with the seed, since he has been left with customer-generated invoice, custom invoice where the expiry dates or the period of sowing date is mentioned. So if he doesn't get the proper results after following all these precautions, he has every right to find the claim compensation from the seed manufacturers. If he is possessing that QR code generated invoice, so because he has been guaranteed by that QR code that this is supposed to give you the required properties or required benefits for quality aspects to him, and if they are not being met, he has every right to claim, make claim with the supplier by producing these QR code generated invoices. So the government also will have the strength to, through the farmer, to make a claim to the seed manufacturer. So therefore, there will not be any scope for disputes between the seed manufacturers and the seed users.
It was very good discussion, sir, especially the seeds which are very fundamental in agriculture. And here, as you rightly said, the traceability, for which we are using various other technologies like color separator is one good thing, gravity separators, or including like dyes one could use, or fluorescent material one could use, and DNA fingerprinting is another method. And all these things with advances in technology, the cost is also coming down. And in the interest of farmers, the government should adopt on a large scale. And definitely, these are some of the ideas I think we would like to present before our viewers. And we'll get back with other integrity aspects, including the seed bill and many other aspects related to irrigation, water, and crop management practices, and marketing, and many other issues are there, right from the production to the consumer level. So the whole value chain systems also are there. So we'll discuss every day one of the topics, sir. And thank you very much for your valuable time today and discussing these important aspects. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.